Hi everyone, my name is Dhara Prajapati and I have completed my master's in the plant pathology. I am MSc plant pathologist. As per the conversation held with Dr. Jaya Pandya sir, I am going to help you to teach role of quarantine in plant disease management. Okay, so let's begin. First of all, quarantine. This word is basically arrived from the French language, which means 40 days period. Okay, and now we will see the exact definition of plant quarantine. So you can write it down with me, so you can write it further in exams. Okay. So basically, it is a legal enforcement on the movement of agricultural commodity from one area to another, or maybe one country. So plant quarantine, it is a legal enforcement on the movement of agricultural commodities from one area to another which is free from the disease. The another area which is free from the disease and the one area which is infected. Okay. Now here you might have gone through the principles of plant disease management in your previous study. So let's begin with that PDM principles. First is avoidance. Second is exclusion. Third is irritation. Fourth is protection. And the fifth one is therapy. So, chemical control and etc. Now, this quarantine measures are comes in the principle of exclusion. Okay? So, with the quarantine measure, there are more other measures which are included in the exclusion. Basically, exclude means the aim of exclusion is to prevent the entry of a particular pest, disease, pathogen to the area which is supposedly free from the particular pest, disease and area. So exclusion also includes seed inspection, crop inspection, seed certification, and plant disease notification. Okay. Now there is also one legal document which is included in the exclusion quarantine measures, which is phytosanitary certificate. Okay, we will see this one in further. So you can write down thoroughly this five measures under the principle of exclusion in the plant disease management. Okay. Now, why this quarantine is important, particularly plant quarantine? So, in the recent time, we are seeing that the corona is having very epidemic. endemic disease in our human localities. Okay, so we are home quarantined. See, this plant quarantine is also the same kind of thing, where in case it is required because a particular area is supposed to be exposed to particular disease in a particular community. So what will be the impact of this disease on the other countries which are free from that particular disease, or there may be the same area of the particular country also. So they will, this disease outbreak will cause the losses of millions of rupees, and to cure that disease and to further rehabilitation of the particular thing which is going on currently. So particularly we have to rebuild the economy also. So it will affect the nation's economy as well as world level economy. Only one disease, yes, only one disease can affect this much if the outbreak occurs. So plant quarantine is most important. Now we have seen the importance of plant quarantine. Now we'll see how this quarantine is enacted. So you might have heard of DIPA, Destructive Insect and Pest Act, which is in 1940. So the authority which implements the plant quarantine and their regulation is DPPQS. Directorate of Plant Protection, Quarantine and Storage. Let me write for you. And Storage, which is located at Faridabad. Stations which are currently working and currently functioning for implementing the plant quarantine. Now we will see different methods. Oh, let me mention all the plant quarantine stations details will be mentioned in the PDF which are given by the Dr. J. Pandya sir. Okay, now we will go into the methods of the plant quarantine. See, there are two types of quarantine. First is domestic one, which is within country. Means between states, between two states in the country, within the country. And the international is the word subject, between nations. Now we'll see the methods. There are six methods. Then that how we can implement the plant quarantine. Okay. First one is complete embargoes. Second one is partial embargoes. Third one is inspection and inspection at the point of origin. Fourth one is inspection and treatment at the point of origin. Fifth one is inspection and treatment at the point of entry. And sixth one is post-quarantine. Uh,
facilities. Okay. Now here comes the complete embargoes. This is stands for when the complete prohibition of the one agricultural commodity within the area, within the state, within the country, or between the country. Complete prohibition means no anything regarding the particular confinement. Then partial embargoes. In the partial embargoes, the importing country is known by the fact that the exporting country has a particular disease in a particular area, but they are treating it, they are treating that consignment and then giving it. So it involves partial embargoes. Then third comes the inspection at the point of origin. So whoever the exporting country or whoever the exporting state within the country should check the particular consignment before the custom go for transportation. So they can inspect that, and if any suspected thing find, then they should treat it. This comes in the fourth one. C. Inspection and treatment at the point of origin. After you inspect, if there is nothing found, then it is good to go. And if there is anything which is suspected, then treatment should be done. Now, fifth one is inspection and the treatment at the point of entry. So here comes the role of importing country. If you are receiving any parcel, then you may have checked it for its trustability. See, it is just like that. The importing country should check the particular parcel before it spread in the country. So it is that inspection, and if anything found suspected, then they should be treated at the point of entry itself, so further spread can be stopped. Now, usage of post quarantine facilities. See, we have completed inspection, treatment, and all of the safety procedures. But sometimes what happens, particular paste which include all the disease, insect and weed, all particular paste is hibernating, so they cannot show the symptoms at that time, which is at the consignment arrival time in the importing area. So in that case, what we can do, we can use the post quarantine facilities where the particular isolated area is given to grow the particular paste, disease, or whatever the plant and planting material is there. Okay, so these are all the methods of plant quarantine, how you can implement. Okay, you can write it down. Now here comes which are different diseases and which are different pests comes under the plant. Okay, so diseases which are of importance of plant quarantine. In particularly India, we are talking about domestic quarantine. Okay, first is apple scab, which is prohibited. This is caused by Manchuria inequalis fungi. So apple scab is a disease which particularly occurring in the HP, which is known as the famous area, we can say apple ball of the India. So the particular entry of this apple fruits in particular time, apple fruits, stalks of the trees and all the related planting material which may contain this disease are prohibited. Okay, from the HP. Then you see, you have to remember which disease is prohibited, which commodity is prohibited from which state and for which disease. Okay, next comes the banana mosaic. This is the viral disease which is caused by virus, banana mosaic virus, and which spreads transmitted by a vector known as banana aphid, Pentalonia nigronervosa. Remember this one. Now banana mosaic is mainly spread from the Gujarat and Maharashtra. So suckers, infected tissue culture, जे रोपा हुआ है टिश्यू कल्चर ना, हाँ, ये અને બીજું કોઈ પણ રિલેટેડ મટીરિયલ કે જે બનાના મોઝેઇક ડિઝીઝથી ઇન્ફેક્ટેડ હોય દે શુડ રિમૂવ ઇટ એન્ડ ઇફ એનીથિંગ ફાઇન્ડ સસ્પેક્ટેડ ફ્રોમ ધીઝ સ્ટેટ્સ ઇટ ઇઝ પ્રોહિબિટેડ. થર્ડ કમ્સ ધ બનાના મંડિકા. This is also another virus with viral release. And Assam, Kerala, and Tamil Nadu. From these three states, the entry of these suckers, planting material, and tissue cultured plants are prohibited from any to any another states. Fourth comes potato wart. This disease is caused by Syngatrium antibioticum, which is a chytrid fungi. So in the West Bengal there is a district named Darjeeling which is famous for the tea. So this West Bengal, from this West Bengal the disease potato wart is spreading in another states. So what they have to do, they should restrict the entry of potato eye tubers and another potatoes which may contain the disease if they find any suspect in particular commodity. So it is currently restricted in all four. Now one nematode is there, which is also potato cyst nematode, Globuderia. The entry of this nematode, the entry of this potato tubers and all the planting material related potato is prohibited from West Bengal only. This both potato wart and potato system. The entry of the potato commodity is restricted to another state in India. Okay, me write it down. See, this is done. Now comes the paste. Which are the paste of current day importer. So there are few, let me write insect to be precise. See, first is mango stone weevil, which is current day important paste. Then sandal scale, then flute scale, and then another insect was, let me remember, coffee berry borer. Coffee berry borer from the southern India, part of southern India, and curling moss. So these five insects are of current importance in India. You may note this. Done. Now, remember I have told you about the phytosanitary certificate. So what is the phytosanitary certificate? It is a legal document. Means in Gujarati we can say Pramar Patra. It is a legal document which states that the particular commodity is a free from the pest. This, it includes for all the pest, disease and weed seeds. So particular commodity is a free from this pest and we have treated it. This certificate should be issued by the exporting area to importing area. It may include the country and with between the country and within the country. Okay, so you may write down the definition. It may be helpful in your exams. Okay, એક એવું પ્રમાણપત્ર કે જે બતાવે છે કે ભાઈ અમારી અમારી કન્ટ્રીમાંથી આવેલું આ પાર્સલ કે જે તમારી કન્ટ્રીમાં આવવા જઈ રહ્યું છે તે પર્ટિક્યુલર પેસ્ટ અને ડિઝીઝથી મુક્ત છે, અને જો તેમાં ડિઝીઝ કે પેસ્ટ હોય તો અમે ટ્રીટ કરેલું છે. ઓકે, સો ધીસ ઇઝ ધ ફાયટોસેનિટરી સર્ટિફિકેટ. It is a legal document which is issued by an exporting country to an importing one, which states that particular consignment is free from the pest and diseases. So, with this definition, we are completing today's session of non-quarantine. Let me know if you are having any query related to this. Okay, you may comment or you may ask to me. There is a Pandya sir is help. Pandya sir is there to help us. Okay, then stay safe, stay home, wear a mask and wash your hands. Bye bye.